Haunted Locations in France. Hey everyone, it's Alexa and welcome back to another video. France is a huge draw card for tourists because you're able to indulge in the finest wine, food, and breathtaking sights. However, if you're like me and like to get off the beaten track, France is crammed with paranormal places that are longing for visitors. Castles, graveyards, churches, and houses that all have a strange tale to tell. So bear with me on these pronunciations and let's get traveling. But before we get into today's video, make sure that you're subscribed and ring the bell so that you never miss any of our upcoming videos. Château de Tressaison. Castles are always a great first stop if you're in need of some paranormal activity. This medieval castle has you covered. It's crammed with murder stories, eerie tales, mysterious deaths, and ghosts. One legend that sticks out involves a bride that was murdered by her own brothers on the morning of her wedding. She's known as the Bride of Tressaison. As if that wasn't scary enough, there's also a ghost room where people have spotted ghosts playing a game of cards, and there's a headless ghost that likes to roam around the castle. Paris catacombs. Just the word catacombs is enough to give you the creeps. So imagine visiting them underneath the streets of Paris. They were opened in the 18th century and housed the remains of around 6 million people, making it one of the largest graveyards in the world. It's made up of 200 miles of dark passageways lined with skulls and skeletons. There are many tunnels that haven't even been explored yet. Sometime in the 19th century, farmers were using the tunnels to plant mushrooms. Château de Comarque. We head to the hillside between Sarlat and Les Aizys in southern France and make a stop at the Château de Comarque. This was an important location during the Hundred Years' War, and one of the most brutal battles took place there. The tragic events have stuck ever since, including the beheading of a young boy that the Earl of Comarque's daughter was in love with. You'd imagine his spirit to wander these hills, but it's the ghost of his horse in a constant search for his master that is often spotted. How sad is that? Père Lachaise Cemetery. A cemetery is a perfect place for ghost hunting, and this particular one is said to be one of the most haunted in Europe. Many well-known names have been buried here, including Edith Piaf, Oscar Wilde, Molière, Marcel Proust, Jim Morrison, and Camille Pissarro. Some reports from visitors include a sense of unease, shivers, eerie feelings, and a feeling of unsettlement. Others have felt a zen-like calmness descend upon them. Look out for the spirits of those buried here, or unusual orbs that have sometimes appeared in photographs taken here. The most famous ghost is Chopin, so be sure to look out for him. Palace and Gardens of Versailles. It's a great place to visit when you're in France, but if you're not keen on bumping into ghosts, best you head somewhere else. Legend says that these gardens are haunted by Marie Antoinette, the last queen of France, who is quoted as saying, "Let them eat cake," when the peasants couldn't even afford bread. Now, there's no evidence that she really said that, but bread took up 50% of a peasant's income during her husband's reign as king. Other stories involve people claiming they have time-warped into the middle of an 18th century party, presumably eating cake. Abbaye de Mortimer. This religious monument is the former Cistercian monastery in the forest of Lyon. It's not a massive tourist attraction, and many would like it to remain that way. It was a place of solitude where Abbot Alexandre brought his monks during the 12th century. Over the centuries, when politics took over and the revolution swept through France, the monastery didn't survive. This is all that remains. Mathilde de Lamperesse, the daughter of the abbaye's founder, is said to still be wandering the grounds in a willowy white dress. Her spirit was captured on camera in 1999, although the image has since been proven a fake, done with lighting and staging. Château de Brissac. Dotting the Loire Valley is Château de Brissac, and many claim it to be one of the most haunted places in France. It was built during the 11th century and then rebuilt during the 17th century. Ghost hunters love this spot, and there are several paranormal tales to emerge. The castle is said to be haunted by Charlotte de Brézé, who was murdered by her husband, Jacques, along with her lover. They lived in the castle during the 1400s, and he caught them in the act and murdered them both. Many say they've heard their wails drift through the castle and are often touched by someone. And when they turn around, there's nobody there. Mont Saint-Michel, Normandy. It's an iconic tourist attraction, but not for the reasons you're thinking. Some like to head there in the hope of catching a glimpse of the ghost of Louis d'Estouteville. During the Hundred Years' War, it was Louis d'Estouteville, commander of the garrison at the abbey, who was responsible for the death of 2,000 Englishmen. Legend tells how the sand around the garrison ran red with the blood of these men, and to date, his ghost still guards the garrison with the same passion as he did in 1434. Château de Blandy-les-Tours. Before this haunted castle was built, the site used to be a necropolis. No wonder there are some weird vibes happening here. All Saints Day is the best day to visit the castle, as it's said to be a day that all the trapped spirits come out to play. The air will be filled with the sounds of wailing, crying, and clanging chains, and your hair will stand on end. One of those spirits will be that of a feudal lord of the manor from the 10th century, a murderer who drifts through the halls carrying a dagger to use on any unsuspecting soul he comes across. Château de Chateaubriand. This exquisite medieval castle is located in Brittany, and it's a firm favorite for tourists and those seeking the paranormal. The castle was founded in the 11th century, and there are two fables attached to it. The one is of Sibyl, the wife of Geoffrey IV of Chateaubriand. Geoffrey joined a crusade in 1252, was jailed in Egypt, and during that time, the French army was destroyed by the plague. Sibyl mourned him terribly, but he returned alive and well. She was so shocked, she died in his arms. Her spirit is still there, in the castle they once called home. The other legend involves a scandalous affair, where the wife of Jean de Laval had an affair with King Francis I. The husband locked her up in her room and poisoned her in 1537. Her ghost appears every year on the 16th of October at the stroke of midnight. Behind her are the ghosts of knights and monks. La Dame Blanche. There's not a specific spot that you might run into this haunted figure, known as the White Lady. Her name is Thérèse de Saint-Clair, and in French, they call her La Dame Blanche. Many drivers say they've seen her hitchhiking, and once she gets picked up, she screams and then disappears. She was once picked up in 1981, and the man said that she disappeared after shouting, "Beware the curb." Dordogne is another place the woman in white is often spotted. Thérèse was locked in her room at the top of the tower for 15 years by her husband for having an affair. She took her last breath in that room, and she was buried somewhere inside the walls. The Notre Dame. Yes, it has burnt and badly, and maybe those that love a conspiracy theory or a haunted tale will put it down to some of the ghosts that are said to live there. Notre Dame Cathedral's first ghost story comes from the 12th century, involving a locksmith who was appointed to install all the locks in the cathedral. It was such a huge job, he asked the devil for help. Within a few days of completing the job, the locksmith died and has been wandering the grounds ever since. A similar story took place in the 13th century, when a blacksmith also requested help from the devil. The doors he installed are all said to have held a curse. There are other famous stories, including that of María, Antonieta, Rivas, Mercado, Castellanos, a Mexican intellectual, writer, feminist, and arts patron. Her lover scorned her in Paris, and she took her own life at the altar of the cathedral. Forêt de Broceliande, Brittany. Forests are already creepy, and this one stems back from the time of King Arthur. The forest has many legends and is where you'll find the Valley of No Return. Legend says this is where Morgan le Fay, the older half-sister of King Arthur, imprisoned her lovers. Gréaux-les-Bains. The little town of Gréaux is a charming place to visit and is known for its pure thermal water and massive fields of herbs, including lavender, rosemary, and thyme. And then there's the haunted castle, of course. This little town has seen a lot and has been involved with every major historical event in French history. The 13th century castle is haunted, and locals don't like going there. If you walk around the area, you're likely to hear bodiless voices drifting in the wind and shadows that come from nowhere. Best to let someone know you're going there before you do. Parc Montsouris. This is a public park situated at the southern tip of Paris. It opened in 1869 and was built by Jean-Charles Affin. It's the perfect setting for a picnic, a run, or an afternoon stroll. Oh, and bumping into ghosts. History states that this park was the perfect spot to test out the guillotine for a start, and the spirit of one person who was murdered by bandits still roams the park. Basilique du Bois Chenu, Domrémy. If you're not satisfied with your ghost hunting, then head here. A church located near Domrémy, which was built in honor of Joan of Arc. She was one of France's heroines during the Hundred Years' War and fought bravely against the English. Then she was burnt at the stake. Her spirit is said to have been seen several times, along with less famous figures. Joan of Arc was canonized in 1920. Château de Bonneguil. This spot is famous as it was the location of Robert Enrico's cult film Le Vieux Fusil, shot in 1975. The building is a marvel to look at and is worth a visit, even if you're not into ghost hunting. This castle was built in the 13th century and was reconstructed near the end of the 15th century. A team of investigators went into the castle to investigate the paranormal activities and reported the following. Pressure on their shoulders, a burning sensation on their skin. They heard shouts and temperatures dropped suddenly. You're welcome to head there to experience it for yourself. And of course, let us know. Have you ever visited any of these haunted sites? If so, was it a frightening experience? Let us know in the comments below. Jardin des Tuileries. This stunning garden is located between the Louvre and the Place de la Concorde and opened to the public in 1667. After the French Revolution, it became a public park. Before you visit, know this. Lurking in and amongst the hedges, flowers, and marble statues is the ghost of the Red Man. He was murdered on these grounds because he was believed to know too much about the crown's private affairs. When sentenced to death, he proclaimed that he knew when the queen would die, and legend says that he appears just before any major event happens in France. He was said to be seen by Marie Antoinette and Napoleon I, and now, quite possibly you.